Around hundreds or thousands of points are located in our body, existing in our body. Even for that condition, there are the one among them, the supreme level of functioning point to be called as a Nichuan, or the pronunciation is called as a Nikuan. So this point is located 2 chun proximal to the ventral wrist crease. This is the ventral wrist crease. You understand, this point is the ventral wrist crease. From here, 2 chun above from this wrist crease. How to find out? You just try to find out the point. So this is 6 chun. From here, this is 6 chun. This is the center. In between these two is the center, is this. Right? From here, again it is divided into 1.5. This is 1.5. That means this point to be called as a 2 chun. Right? So when there is the problem with just your applying in between the two tendons, in between two tendons you need to activate this point. In fact, this point is good point to treat for the morning sickness, especially for the first gravidex positive, or maybe first pregnancy positive. Even that time, the most of the women will get the problem is like morning get up, they causes the nausea, bitterness and vomiting sensation, or vomiting also. Even for the travel sickness, the people will get motion sickness, causes the nausea, vomiting by going by the car, by going by the ship, or by going by the boat or bus or flight, train. So even anything related to this point to be work as an anti-emetic, that means it controls the nausea and vomiting. The stomach energy ascends the upward direction, that passes to the upward direction rather than descending. So this point to be work for the chest also, the stomach also. At the same time, I told you this pericardium cyst is the Luo connecting point. This point to be called as a rimic point, and this point is the distal point for the chest also. So therefore, this ascends upward direction and communicating to the chest. From the chest, it communicating to the triple warmer meridian as well. So which is communicating to the ascending direction, then middle direction, then descending direction as well. So therefore, this point is good point to treat for the numerous diseases which I told you, like pericardium 5. But at the same time, this point is a distal point for the spleen, distal point for the lungs, distal point for the heart, distal point for the thorax, and distal point for the esophagus, distal point for the stomach, right? So many indications, all these related organ related diseases, this point to be activated as a distal point. Anything the organ is malfunction, even that condition, this point to be activated. Once you activate this point, you make sure that, so don't apply very deeper level. If you apply deeper level, you understand you are hurting to the medial nerve. So the point is located internally, now called as a medial nerve. So when you damage us to that medial nerve, we should not do the trauma to that nerve, because of that causes the issues, because of people will get the CTS, which we call as a carpal tunnel syndrome. So that problem also reflected, even that condition also can be treatable by the same point. At the same time, we should not damage. Remember always, when pericardium meridian you are activating, you should not do any electrical stimulation to this particular meridian. Once you do the stimulation, the hand going to hijack or jump like anything, and it get the major vibration to this particular point. So therefore, always you remember, you should not give anything is the connectivity, electrical connectivity. Already there is the electrical nerve connectivity is there. The nerve, when we do is the nerve velocity conductivity test. So that time we come to know what kind of the compression is there, how much current is passing to the electrical nerve in that particular nerve. You understand, it's a very rapid level it passes the electrical velocity. So if you do again a stimulation to this particular point, again it having the higher level velocity, which leads to the problem. So therefore, you understand, once you apply the needle, it is recommended to apply just a surface level. But once you insert the deeper level, every individual patient will get the Every individual patient gets the vibration. Every patient will get the pulsation by activating this point. So therefore, it elevates the vasovagal tone. At the same time, it gets sometimes is the feels the fatigueness and vertigo and then perspiration. So this all are related to the common and benign complication by doing acupuncture by activating this particular point. So therefore, you need not to worry. But however, in the beginning stage is not much recommended. Better you wanted to use this point is recommended to use only the you by using the micro needle, or you just you can use the half chun needle, but you should not use the needle is 1 chun and 1.5 chun. You should not go deeper level, so that causes the benign complication again. You understand? So therefore, the pericardium 6 point is taking care for the upper extremities, and then at the same time, Cheoxin point, which we called as a kidney 8 point, is taking care for the lower extremities. You understand? When you wanted to treat for the upper limbs, can be treatable by activating single point. That point to be called as a Nikuan. So at the same time, the lower extremities can be treatable, or lower limbs to be treatable by activating single point. That point to be called as a Cheoxin. You understand? This point is a meeting point of the 3 in meridians, that is spleen, liver, kidney on the lower limbs. At the same time, this point also communicating, one, the medial nerve is good, then musculocutaneous nerve also good. At the same time is the phrenic nerve also good. At the same time, which is supporting to that radial nerve. At the same time, it is ulnar nerve also supporting this medial nerve. So therefore, where is the origin to cause the problem? Anything, the wrist related issues or the elbow related issues, that to be regulated by activating the cervical region C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1. These are the regions of the phrenic nerve, musculocutaneous nerve, and then medial nerve is descending from the downwards direction from that place and communicating to the terminal of the fingers. If anything related to that condition, certainly we try to focus and treat to the neural segments. At the same time is the local points. At the same time, we have to find out the motor points. So which motor physiology is weaker than the normal, which muscles are affected to causing this problem. So therefore, try to find out the nerve impingement is there, treat for the nerve. At the same time, there is the muscles are affected, treat for the muscles. At the same time, the most of the acupuncture points also related to the muscular meridian points. At the same time, the points are in the motor level also located. So which regulates to the nervous system, which regulates to the muscular system, which regulates to the skeletal system as well. But however, the tendon in between its point is located midway between the two tendons. Then you understand anything the musculocutaneous related diseases are there, musculotendinous related diseases are there. The either you look at this is the Achilles tendon, or you take it the any kind of the tendon is there is an issue. So that condition also, even arthritis condition also can be treatable. Due to that reason, this point also good point to treat for the knee pain. When there is the knee pain, right side is there, you just activate the left side pericardium 6. When there is the vice versa, if just apply the 2 minutes stimulation to this particular point is the manual partial stimulation, and ask him to regulate and move the knee movements, and certainly the patient will get changes in the knee region. When we look at the another indication, which we call as a pericardium 6, is good point to treat for the infertility, at the same time for the uterus related diseases, even the irregular menstruation, irregular, you know, dysmenorrhea, difficulty in menstruation, or the premenstruation syndromes, all are indicated to the pericardium 6 also. When there is an irregular menstruation also can be regulated by activating this point to be called as a pericardium 6. So among them, thousands of points, among them is the key point to be called as a pericardium 6. But make sure you should not disturb that medial nerve, but ask them to patient itself, give the manipulation. The manual stimulation can be recommended by activating this point to treat for the numerous diseases. Right?